All right, so we're going to go over the chords on Wooly Bully. These are pretty simple. There's just three chords we need to know, and you already know them. So we know G, and then we need to know C and D7. So all these chords are in the Yellow Submarine song, so nothing new. So the rhythm is pretty cool. It's fun to play. It's simple once you get the hang of it anyways. I'm going to go, there's three parts in the song. There's an intro, there's a verse, and a chorus. I'm going to start with the intro. The intro goes like this on a G chord. The whole thing is G. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. All right, so piece of cake, right? I'm going to play along with that just so you can hear what that sounds like. So here it goes. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, so there's the intro. Now on the verse, one guitar is going to be playing this. And I'm going to send you the video on that, but I really want you to focus on the chords in this case. The chords, we're just going one, two, and three, four, one, two, and three, four. Or you could go one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, four. So we do not play on one, and we don't play on three. We only play on two and then four and. So one, two, and. So that's always a down up, right? Down on the numbers, up on the ends. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, and three. So one more major, there's four of these total. Okay, here's our C chord. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three. Here's G again. Two and three, four and one. Okay, now one major of D7, two and three, four, C7, two and three, four, G. Two and three, four, one, and two, and three, and four, and. So when I said there's three chords, I really meant there's four. There's a C chord, and there's a variation called C7. All that is a C chord, but if you can add your pinky on the third string, third fret, you get that sound. So you have C chord, no pinky, and then C7 with the pinky on the third string, third fret. Either one works fine actually. So if you can't quite catch the C for right now or C7, work on that C chord. Okay, and then at the end of the verse, the only thing you heard different was on the rhythm anyways, that D7, we went one and two and three and four. So what I'm doing is not playing on one, but I play on all the other eighth notes. So it sounds like this. One and two and three and four. Again. One and two and three and four. So the last four measures of the verse, there's only one chord per major, right? So we switch chords every major. So that's four different D7, C7, G, D7. So it's bam, 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 bam. It goes pretty quick. So you got to make sure you're counting one, two and three, four and one, two and three, four and one, two and three. Four and one, and then so that last major is like the turnaround. It is getting us back to where we want to go on G. So when we go to the chorus, it's exactly the same rhythm. And if you notice on your chart, it says we have G seven times. That means you got to keep track of that. We're going one, two, and three, four, two, and three, four, three, two, and three, four, et cetera, up till we get to seven. And then you'll notice we're just back to two majors of C, two majors of G, and then the same last four majors to turn around. D7, C7, G, back to D7. That is basically the entire tune. That's all you really have to know. The choruses are always the same. The intro, or sorry, the verses are the same. And then on your chart, you'll see something that says interlude. That's the same as the intro. And the outro is also the same as the intro. I'm going to play along with this now with the recording just so you can kind of get the feel for it, and then that should hopefully get you where you need to go. Okay, here we go from the top. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, three, four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, three, four, and so. C, right? Back to G for two majors. D7, C, G. Up, down, up, down. Okay, now here's our 7. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. C now. 2 and 3 for two majors. Back to G. 1. Okay, D7. 1, 2, and 3, 4. C7. G, 2 and 3, 4, 1. Up, down, up, down, up, down. So it's gonna do this again. Second time in the chorus. I think we're on 5, 6, 7. Yeah. Back to G. So here comes our one major of each. 1, 2, and 3. C7. Back to G. Then D7. Here's our interlude. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's our solo. Same thing as the verse. C7, or C, I mean. G. D7. C7. Back to G. D7. Now we're on the chorus. 1, 2, and 3. Here's our third time. 4, 2, and 3. 4, 5, 2, and 3. 4, and 1, 2, and 3, 4. Last track, actually, sorry. 1, 2, and 3. Back to G. D7. C7. G. Finally, D7. Here's our outro. Same as the intro. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. So that's the entire tune, short and sweet. A lot of fun. Thanks. See you next time.